I'm with Shane Smythe, a citrus grower from the Sunraysia region, and he's built this trunk band sprayer from some obsolete machinery he's had around the orchard and also from some parts he's gotten from a supplier. Shane, could you just tell us a little bit about your trunk band sprayer?
Yeah, we built this machine. It was a bit of trial and error. I'll give you a bit of an idea on how it works. We start at the head down here. We had to get spray as we went past the trunk to wrap around the trunk a bit, and then when you come back the other side it meets up. So we got these old nozzles off an old sprayer. They're hand adjusted, so you can't have too wide a spray, otherwise you'll get a chemical on the leaves, which is MRLs and all that sort of stuff. So we started off with two jets, and that wasn't quite getting enough chemical on, so I added another jet underneath there, and that works quite well. Works very well, actually. So from there, we put a solenoid under here. That's just a guard to stop the branches from tearing it off. It's operated from a press button system in the cabin. I had to put a brake back on it because if you hit trees, you've got to have a bit of give or it'll smash it. Then I had to put a wheel underneath here for uneven ground, because if that bar dropped down too far, you'd be pulling jets and things like that off. And from there, because you can't see underneath the tree, we got a reversing camera and put that on, and the screen's on the dash in the tractor. The camera works very well, but we've found a problem with it. This is a project in operation. We're changing things as we go. It needs to come in to about here, because when the canopy comes down, it obscures the camera and you can't see the butt all the time. So that's a job that's got to be done before next season. Like I said, it's hydraulically operated. So in tight areas, you can it goes right up with a one-way ram. Now, we had to use the one-way ram because when the wheel hits the ground, it just lifts, rides up and down as it needs to. If you have a two-way ram, it's rigid and you'll end up bending something. So it lowers under its own weight.